It's important that you know that if you're an investor or you're seeking to be an entrepreneur, there are some things you should do before you start. In this video coming up next, I'm going to talk to you about several things you need to do before you decide to blow up the current job that you have, the friends that you have, and the associates that you're around who are giving you the foolish enthusiasm to think that you can go start a business without knowing these facts first. Stay tuned. Now you may be saying to yourself, well, that's not true, Primo. You can't tell me that I can't just leave my job because I don't save. Let me go into more detail. Because one of the things that's important to know is this. Yes, you're gonna fail because you're already structured to fail. Not just because you have that $30,000 windfall, difference between the 50 and the 20,000 that you had the ability to save. It's because your entire life, all the credit, the car, the rent or home that you own was based on 50,000. But this euphoric emotion that you now receive to tell you that you can go out here and liberate the world with this new idea that can change the footprint of America and you'll become the next Jeff Bezos is all being ran without objective truth. The reality is, in order for you to go out and start a business, we have to look at some basic truth that you need to be aware of. Currently, every year you file for your federal taxes and you receive a check, and you receive a check from the state, unless you have other obligations that you defaulted on, and you may not get that check. But if you get the check, we need to understand this, that the check that you receive, you want to continue. Currently, you work at a job. Each month and every quarter, 941s are paid by your employer. They withhold that amount of money off the top of your pay and you receive your net income. So currently, there is a system in place that allows you to receive a federal tax because you don't get paid your federal tax. They withhold it. So automatically, when you start this business, and you only have $20,000, you're gonna see a shortfall in your personal life, and you're gonna see a behavior that says, you know, well, I'm going to embezzle from my company. That's right, I'm gonna use a major word that gets a lot of people locked up, a lot of people disrespected, and a lot of people brokenhearted. We're talking about you embezzling. No one else, just you. You embezzle from yourself. That's the first embezzler of most startup companies, is the individual. And then they say, oh no, I don't get a paycheck. I pay myself a draw. You pay yourself a what? Your accountant told you to pay yourself a draw because you don't have the ability to save and they wanted to get paid in spite of the fact they wasn't honest with you. You don't have the ability to start this company. Stay on your job where there is a group of individuals. If it's a privately held company and it's not public traded, those privately held individuals have enough resources and funds in order for you to be able to draw out of their business bank account and receive a pay, a continual pay. That continual pay allows you to be able to receive that check every 2 weeks. And that is not from this year, that is from last year. So if all you saved is $20,000 and it took you a year to do it, you have a little bit longer. I would recommend you stay on your job for 5 more years, draw into that job, allow yourself to develop the behavior of saving so that you understand that before you can even pay yourself, you have to be able to save for yourself. Because now you're taking after-tax dollars that's already been taxed, place it into your business account. That's right, into your business account. And then you're gonna tax that same money again because you're gonna pay yourself a W-2 on already taxed money. Oh, you didn't know that happens? So you're not ready to even start a business if you don't even realize that it happens. Well, you say, well, my first 5 years, I'm not gonna pay myself anything. So for 5 years, you're not gonna pay into Social Security, which exists today? That's right, Social Security exists today. You're not gonna pay into it? Second, on top of that, you're not gonna get a federal income tax and a state income tax check? This year, next year, for the first 5 years? Oh, what kind of pride are you operating with? This got to be the most absurd thing that I have heard. And it actually is. Because this is the projective path of most entrepreneurs who don't understand about business. Enthusiasm is the enemy of the idiot that uses it without also taking side by side some objective truth. Who is in your circle? Who are you talking to? You gotta get some people around you who way smarter than you, because apparently that ain't gonna work if you keep operating on your own initiative to do things in this magnitude. Now, you don't have to like what I'm saying, but it ain't gonna stop me from telling you this. I have one responsibility, and that is to tell you the truth objectively.